pleasure to meet you, sir.
Oh, the pleasure's all mine. I've been a fan for a long time.
How's it going?
Pretty good. How about you?
Yeah, good.
Okay. Do you like being asked questions about your music?
Not really. Sorry, I'm so dry in interviews. I'm like, yes.
What are you thinking about in the interview?
I don't know. I'm just zone out. Do you have any hidden skills?
How hidden? Things people don't know that I do normally.
Yeah, things that you're good at.
Pretty good at ironing shirts.
Yeah, nice. Did you start playing music as a child?
Yeah, I kind of got into this weird avant-garde piano performances in the living room.
So was piano your first instrument, would you say?
Probably, yeah. I don't know if it,
nice.
Instrument is the right way to describe it. And I used to look at National Geographic covers, angelfish or anglerfishes with these luminous bones that would light their way around, and I'd play this song and then I'd freak myself out and run out of the room. Do you,
nice.
Yeah, really nice. Has music always been there for you?
Not really. I think it was around me growing up because Dad is a musician and Mum used to sing opera.
Oh, wow.
So one side was operatic and the other side was country music.
That's a good combo.
So that's, I think I didn't start playing music until I was about 15.
What did you start there doing?
Drumming.
Oh, yeah.
And singing.
Mm. What song did you play today?
Something's Wrong.
And why did you choose that song?
Because I wanted to do a cover that sounded completely different from the original, because that's always a fun challenge.
Thinking at all about the next album?
Yeah, a lot.
What are the thoughts that come to mind when you think about that?
What's it gonna be? What's it gonna sound like?
Is there
what's
any
it about?
Things that are, if you're thinking about it, that you know you want to have as a part of it, whatever that might be?
I want to experiment with some synth, Bowie vibes.
You have a crystal ball. You have it covered with a silk cloth. Leave it in a special room in your house. You walk into the room and you can feel energy pulsating out. Lift off the scarf. What do you see when you look into the crystal ball?
Tsunamis.
Tsunamis.
Unfortunately.
Where's it coming from?
Down in the CBD, knocking over the Sky Tower.
Does it make it as far up as Tanuki's Cave?
Yeah.
Up to K Road?
Yeah.
Up to the Domain?
Probably.
Do you think if you were on top of Mount Eden, you'd be safe?
I think so.
What about Mount Roskill?
I can't remember the last time I've been to Mount Roskill. Oh, God, sorry, my answer was so morbid, but if you had a crystal ball, what would you see in it in the future?
Acceptance, I would like to say.
Mm-hmm.
Instead of people fighting it all the time.
Yeah.
Love, maybe. But I don't know, that's probably a bit hippie-ish.
No.
Like for everybody, not on a personal level. Man. The world needs an electric shock and a good scrub, I reckon.
Little black boots, pin back bangs, long trench coat and black. Faux burling is, it's a real thing, little cat eyes on a string.
It's interesting that the song I played of yours and the one you played of mine have got pretty much the same chords, right? But they're really different songs.
Why did you choose Hellhole?
Because it's such a strong song. It just carries itself. I felt really lucky because it was such an easy song to play in terms of its strength as a song. I didn't have to freak out about it. It was just, you could really lean into it.
Myself, I'll never belong to the hello. And I'm not coming out, unless it's on my own accord. All of my life I'll never belong to the hello. Promise myself I'll never belong to the hello. Feeling of suffocation, and I'm not coming out unless it's on my own accord. All of my life I'll never belong to the hello. Promise myself I'll never belong.
What are you working on?
I'm working on my solo album, number 10.
Wow, number 10. What do you think you've learnt from having done 9 albums so far?
Don't get too serious about them. Keep on making them.
Yeah.
don't get stuck on them.
So how many albums did it take for you to learn that?
Probably five.
Mm.
First album, almost an accident. Second album, you feel like you know what you're doing. The third album's usually you find a way to let go of that incredible control that you have over the second one. Fourth album felt to me like, oh yeah, I kind of think I know what I'm doing now, maybe. Five was like, oh, maybe you don't actually know what to do. And number six to me was, it was like a look under the hood. But someone said, maybe I didn't really want to see all that greasy old engine. Number seven was a live album. It was like an album I probably should have always made. Eight was album with a band that felt like a real push. Number nine was bringing more elements in that weren't just me, like writing a lot with some other influences come in. This one feels like it's had a few starts, trying out different possibilities before committing to something. Don't hold back. If you think it's not good, tell me. Let's be really clear and upfront.
Mm.
I'm not going to freak out if you say it sounds like a load of shit.
Yeah.
I just don't care at this stage, you know? I just want it to be interesting or good rather than worried about if my feelings got hurt. I think we met like over there outside smoking in that smoking courtyard here at Marlon's show, was it?
Yeah. It was a full moon.
It was a full moon, wow. And it was in that window we had of lockdowns, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Having gone through a pandemic and all those things grind to a halt, do you think they'll ever get back to normal? Or what we used to think of as normal?
No.
Please expand.
Yeah. The value of music and arts, in my mind, has kind of gone up.
Yeah, having it taken away so people understand what it is worth now.
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you think there's things we can do as artists to make it last longer, help it retain its value?
In some ways, maybe not to thrash playing all the time.
Mm.
Do you know what I mean?
Well, Aimee, I have to say it's been really nice having a chat. Thank you for being here today, sharing your time with the good people.
Thank you very much, kind sir. It was lovely to meet you.